The shadow overtake us.
Hey guys, it's Kyle. Today we're going to be talking about the level 43 spell Superheat in the normal spellbook. What this spell does is it takes your ores and turns them into bars without use of a furnace. Now, to use this spell, you're going to need fire runes or a fire staff. Nature runes for each cast, one nature rune for each cast, and the ore is required to make the bar. Now, a lot of high levels like to do this because since it's using both magic and smithing techniques, you get both magic and smithing experience, which is like knocking out, you know, two birds with one stone, is how I think of it. So, it's not the best experience in either skill, but it's decent experience for both skills. If you have some money to waste, I suggest using Superheat on gold ore to make gold bars with goldsmithing gauntlets. To get goldsmithing gauntlets, you need to do the Family Crest quest. I don't know the requirements, but it shouldn't be too bad. I'll check for you. I haven't done the quest yet because I don't have it need to, but it looks like I have all the requirements. You do have to kill a level 170 demon to acquire these gauntlets. So be ready for that if you're lower level. But if you superheat gold, it's really good smithing and pretty decent magic experience at the same time. Now you may be thinking, you said it costs a lot. I said it costs a lot of money. So what if I don't have a lot of money? Well, that's only for gold. You can still not use much money or even make a profit doing other bars. Now, I don't know about lower level, but I know that steel, mithril, adamant, and runic bars make profit. So, if you are at least 30 smithing, you should be able to make a profit with this technique and get some decent magic and smithing experience at the same time. I don't know the rates off the top of my head, but I'll find them out and I'll put them in the description for you. But I suggest training magic this way all the time, you know, or just use magic with something that, you know, it's efficient. Because I see people, like, there's gotta be somebody somewhere. Well, normally there are a whole bunch of people standing around alching here, and I'm thinking, why are you alching and losing money? I mean, you could at least be superheating and, you know, knocking out two birds with one stone, like I said. Alching is decent experience and it's easy, but I don't see why they wouldn't just do something else. Because, I mean, this is really easy too. And I prefer this over alching. I really don't like to alch. And I'll make a guide on some other magic techniques you can use instead of alching that are a lot more efficient in my future guides. So that about wraps things up. Superheating is really efficient. It's good for smithing and magic experience, and you can even make a profit sometimes. So if you have any questions, ask me in the comments or in a message, and I'll try to answer it as best as I can. So that's pretty much it, guys. I'll talk to you later.